Well, we've already done Mario Teaches Typing 1. It's about time we do Mario Teaches Typing 2 for the PC. Now, this game came years after the first Mario Teaches Typing, and it's got some similar elements as the first one, such as the crazy computer-generated Charles Martinet Mario head just flying all around. Hey, I'm a Mario! I'm a rocket! Woo-hoo! So yeah, that's kind of scary. I'm surprised they kept that of all things in this version. But one thing this has that the first one didn't really have a whole lot of is story. This has these animated cutscenes between your typing adventure levels of Mario and Luigi. Okay, so here's the story. Mario and Luigi have this magic typewriter, which explodes into like three pieces for some reason, and they have to track them down. And they're looking around for them through, well, sort of through the Mushroom Kingdom. It's more so just outside of a castle. But there's water levels and everything, and you know, the basic platforming Mario Land level. But yeah, what's weird is the animation. It looks almost like this animation was done in Paintbrush, or one of those very basic computer programs from like the early 90s. And you see things in this that are strange for Mario World. I mean, like, there's a part where Mario and Luigi need to cross a bridge, but a Koopa Troopa has put an explosive on the bridge, and then you see the Koopa Troopa looking all dastardly and evil all close up on him, doo-doo-doo, as he pushes the lever and bridge explodes. And so that's interesting. And then there's one part where Mario and Luigi get inside the castle. There's a bunch of Koopa Troopas all like gambling or playing poker or something like that. I'm trying to remember. And I think it was Mario throws a Koopa shell at them, and the Koopa Troopa sees it and goes, ah! Starts screaming as he gets taken out by the shell. Oh, you know what I hate about PC games like this? Is how when you get a new PC, it seems like each upgrade makes it less and less compatible with old games. My new computer doesn't work with these old games, and I'm gonna have to get some computer that's like 15 years old to be able to play these games, because I don't know a whole lot about computers. I'm not a computer wizard or anything, so I have all these old PC games that I can't really play. That's why I prefer console gaming, because, you know, I got my GameCube, and I'll always have my GameCube for when I want to go back to those GameCube games. I've got my Super Nintendo. Whenever I want to go and play those Super Nintendo games, I just stick them in the Super Nintendo. It's easy. It's simple. Whereas a PC doesn't feel like it's something you hold on to, like a Super Nintendo or a GameCube or a Genesis. You know, a PC is something that you get a new one and you throw out your old one, or you sell it for parts or something because it's obsolete. You don't need it anymore because your new one has faster internet. Your new one has better software for doing your homework or typing out your scripts or whatever else. And that's my little rant about PC gaming. Mario Teaches Typing 2 definitely, I'd say, is the better of the two games, which you would expect it being a sequel, but still not even worth your time. Anyway, thanks for watching Daily Toast. Tune in tomorrow for another Daily Toast.